Generally speaking, a fire aboard a spacecraft is what we would call a bad thing. So why is NASA setting a fire on purpose? The reason comes down to safety. NASA is planning a series of three experiments called the Spacecraft Fire Experiments, or SAFFIRE. The two purposes of SAFFIRE are to investigate microgravity's effects on a large fire and to see if NASA's approach to fire protection is effective. In the mission overview, NASA points out that most habitable structures undergo extensive, full-scale fire safety testing. The same isn't true for spacecraft. While astronauts have used flames in experiments before, it was always on a small scale. The biggest flames in previous experiments measured no larger than 10 centimeters, or about 4 inches in length or width. SAFFIRE will change that. In the first of the experiments, scheduled to launch on March 22nd, a chamber in a Cygnus cargo craft will play the role of an orbital fire pit. First, the Cygnus will dock with the International Space Station to deliver materials for other experiments. Then it will detach from the ISS and move off to a safe distance. A thin panel of cotton and fiberglass that's 0.4 meters wide and 1 meter long will serve as fuel. A hot wire on one edge of the panel will ignite the panel once the experiment begins. What will happen when the material catches fire? We don't really know. Microgravity might limit how large a fire can get, or it may turn into a raging blaze that would pose a serious threat to crew and equipment. The sensors will measure the experiment's flame growth, intensity, and chamber oxygen levels. The Cygnus spacecraft will remain in orbit for a week to make sure NASA can download all the data from the experiment. Then Cygnus and SAFFIRE 1 will be deorbited and break up upon re-entry to Earth's atmosphere. NASA has two more SAFFIRE experiments planned after this one. SAFFIRE 3 will use the same sort of material as SAFFIRE 1, but SAFFIRE 2 will have a range of materials used in spacesuits and spacecraft to see exactly how flame-resistant they really are in microgravity. NASA hopes to use this information to design better spacecraft and spacesuits for long-distance, prolonged space flights. That'll come in handy when we're ready to head to Mars and beyond. One thing you can count on, whether you're on Earth or Mars, is that you'll learn all about the most interesting stories in the solar system at now.howstuffworks.com. So make sure to stop by every day. Being a Martian is no excuse.